There's a book series out there called A Series of Unfortunate Events. The series follows adventures of three siblings called the Baudelaire. It's been a long time since I've read this. Violet Baudelaire is eldest. She's 14 and she's an inventor. Klaus is the middle child and he loves books. And then Sunny likes to bite stuff and cook things. She's the youngest.
That was a big drop off in the
she's like a baby. She's like a baby and she has one big
I have talent. She likes to bite things.
The children are orphaned by their parents after they are killed in a fire in the family mansion. They are sent to live with a distant relative named Count Olaf after briefly living with Mr. Poe, a banker in charge of the orphans' affairs. The siblings discovered that Count Olaf intends to get his hands on the enormous Baudelaire fortune, which Violet is to inherit when she reaches 18 years of age. In the book, he attempts to marry Violet, pretending it is the storyline of his latest play, but then the plan falls through when Violet uses her non-dominant hand to sign the marriage document, thus causing the marriage not to be successful. After the crowd realizes, Count Olaf manages to escape with his henchmen.
For the record,
yeah.
If you sign your marriage license with your non-dominant hand, you're still probably married. If you had the ceremony and the witnesses and that, signing with your wrong hand, you're still probably need to get that a divorce.
Yeah. Number one, the parents are killed at a fire in the family mansion. Is it reasonable that they go to this banker, Mr. Poe, after the parents die? Is that something that could happen in real life?
That's confusing to me. Most parents can use a will to nominate guardians of their children. So whoever would... In Georgia, like a testamentary guardian, a will name someone that if I have a kid under 18 who should take care of them if both legal parents are dead. So they would nominate someone. I guess they could have nominated a banker.
Okay, cool. So they go to Mr. Poe, which is relatively reasonable, not totally unheard of. They then say they looked for family relatives. They couldn't find anybody. And then they found like a distant uncle named Count Olaf. How likely is that? And is that possible?
That's more plausible.
Okay.
That they look for the nearest family member to take care of them. So that's plausible.
Sweet. That's plausible. Great. Is he entitled to a portion of this estate?
No. Okay. So I'm going to bring this back to Georgia because of the law I know. So if he's managing their money, he would be a conservator and he's entitled to compensation for it. So he'd probably have compensation for management of it, but he's not, which is usually a percentage or actual fees. It would be supervised by the probate court.
Gotcha. Okay. And so basically he would just have to spend that money in the best interest of the children?
According to a budget.
Gotcha.
That was approved by the judge.
He ends up obviously not doing this, and instead his plan is to get this inheritance in another way, right? So he's going to then trick the eldest daughter into marrying him.
That's the part that's confusing me. Isn't he? He's our distant uncle.
Exactly.
And he's trying to marry her.
So is that not, that's my next question. Is that not cool? You can't marry your family members? I mean, not that I would ever want to.
I was just looking this up for a client because we had a
really?
Inheritance that might have been voidable.
Oh, okay.
So... Uncles and nieces cannot get married.
Okay. What about second uncle?
It's unclear. When it gets further out, it's probably legal.
Okay.
Incidentally, cousins can get married.
But really?
Yeah. Georgia's weirdly weird. Cousins, fine, but uncles, no.
Okay.
Uncles, nieces, uncles, aunts cannot marry nieces and nephews. But once you get more remote out, then it gets like...
Yeah.
Anything's up for grabs.
Jesus.
But I'm pretty sure you can, like, a distant uncle is probably someone you could marry if it's like 2, 3, 4 things away.
So that's my other question is she's technically like a minor or whatever. Can you marry someone before the age of 18?
I don't remember. I think you can marry someone. You're pretty close. So I think around 16, 17 in Georgia, you can get married without parental consent.
Wow.
Okay. I could certainly say 18, yes. But I want to say maybe it's a little younger. Under Georgia law, it's probably a voidable marriage.
Yeah.
So it might not be void on its face, but you could probably automatically get it voided if she asked the court to. So she probably couldn't get rid of it by signing with her other dominant hand, but she could probably go to the court and be like, no, he's my fiduciary, and also I'm 16 or 17, and that's a weird marriage.
Yeah.
And a judge is probably going to be like, annulled. That's weird. But if she married him, even if they rule it's a good marriage, which I guess they could.
Yeah.
The inheritance is still separate property.
From my understanding, once you get married, then you have joint property, and you have
to,
when you get divorced,
you get married,
you split it in half.
Yeah, exactly. So I have person A brings their bucket of stuff in and person B has their bucket of stuff.
Yep.
Those are separate property.
Okay.
But then the second they get married, the clock starts running on joint property, on marital property.
Okay.
So everything of the marriage gets split 50-50 if they get divorced, but they still keep their bucket of separate property.
Okay, so that's preceding the marriage.
Yeah, anything preceding the marriage.
Gotcha.
Inheritances, regardless of whether you inherit before the marriage or during the marriage, it's still considered to be separate.
Let's say his plan is then to secretly murder her.
So if he was her actual spouse and he didn't murder her, he would inherit it. He'd be her sole heir unless they had a kid, which would even be more horrifying. But if the probate court judge thinks it's likelier than not you killed the person, you won't inherit from them.
So, Dan, so hold on a minute. What I'm hearing is that this book is totally legit, other than the left-handed.
It could be. Modern law might not have changed that much, depressingly.
Yeah.
But to the court, there'll be a lot more protections for the kid's money.
Gotcha. Okay.
And honestly, shame on the parents for not estate planning better.
Yeah.
There's like about 50 problems with their estate plan that I would just rattle off. Starting with the fact that they're going to leave a big fortune to an 18-year-old. That's their game plan? And also, why is it always seem to go to their oldest daughter? What are the other two?
Yeah.
Under Georgia law, typically there's no will be split into three equal shares where each one gets their third when they turn 18. But like, shame on them for not planning well. It is a problem. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this useful or at least enjoyable. Listening to us rip apart the great legal questions from the depths of the internet. It would help us out if you could like, share, or leave a comment below this video. Also, if you want to protect your family through the estate planning process, please give us a call. Our direct number is 404-738-9538. And you can also leave us an email at the address below.